弟兄姐妹平安。
That's all the Chinese I'm going to use today.
接下来我都会用英文。
We'll pull up the PowerPoint. So my name is Andrew. The topic that we're going to talk about today is how we can go digital and to mobilize the next generation.
今天我要讲的是如何用电子数位化来帮助我们的下一代可以更多参与宣教。
Our organization name is called Indigitus.
我服务的这个机构叫做 Indigitus.
Maybe you're wondering, I don't know what this word means.
如果你不懂这个字是什么意思
It's because we made it up.
很正常，因为这是一个创造出来的字。
It's two words.
是两个字的组合。
Indigenous and digital.
第一个字呢，就是 indigenous.
And the second word is digital.
它代表的是，第一个字是原住民或是在地的，第二个字是数位化。
Our three main values are missional, open to all, and collaborate.
所以我们代表的这我们代表的信念呢，就是宣教，所有人都可以参与，而且是一个合作的伙伴关系。
So again, the topic today is how we could go digital to mobilize the next generation.
所以今天我要讲的就是如何用电子数位化来帮助我们下一代更多参与宣教。
And primarily, we're trying to figure out how to integrate our faith, our tech, and missions.
我们可以把我们的信仰、科技能够做一个好的组合在宣教上面。
This is a little bit about my background. Logos just make it a little bit easier to tell the story.
这个是我要介绍我自己。
And basically, I grew up in corporate consulting. I did corporate for 10 years, and I've been doing non-profit for 10 years.
基本上我之前呢在业界工作，接下来我进入宣教的机构。
Okay, so why digital strategies?
为什么我们要进入电子数位化呢？
Our hope is to help you understand we need to take the gospel to make it accessible to anyone, anytime, anywhere.
因为这可以帮助我们让福音不受任何时间、空间的限制，可以让任何人都可以有机会听到。
I'm sure a lot of us are interested in global missions.
我相信我们很多人对全球宣教都是有负担的。
Well, did you know that over 65% of the 1040 window are on the internet?
但你知道，在我们所熟知的这个北纬十到四十度之窗当中，有65%的人他们都是会上网的。
And 63% of the people spend 7 hours a day on the internet.
而且63%的人，他们每天超过7个小时都在网络上。
And what are they doing on the internet?
那他们在这网络上做什么呢
？Well, let's continue to see that on Discord.
我们在 Discord 这个数位平台上面
，they have over 13,000 users. They have over 13,000 users here, and online right now, there's about almost 2,000 people online.
在现在你可以看到有超过13,000个人在Discord 这一个数位网络交流平台上面。
This is an online community that is continuing to grow.
这是一个网络的平台，它继续的成长。
It was acquired by Microsoft for billions of dollars.
当时 Microsoft 就把这个Discord 这个买下来。
We'll look at another one.This topic right here, what stops Muslims from accepting Christianity?
比如说在上面可能会讨论这个是什么让穆斯林不接受基督教呢
And look at how many messages have already been sent.
你可以看到上面已经有超过10,000个的信息在回应
That's just within the last few hours.
这只是刚过的几个小时的数据而已
If you want to be part of God's global mission,
如果你想要参与上帝全球的宣教
we need to think about digital strategies.
那我们就要开始想数位化
What about VR church?
或者是我们看到这个虚拟的一个教会。
I know VR has a lot of different implications, but the point is, this is one church with over 1,600 members, and right now there's 300 people online.
你可以看到这是一个虚拟的教会，它上面注册已经有1,600多个会员。
And when they're online, on average, they're spending 90% of their content on secular content, and only 10% are Christian or spiritual.
当他们在网络上的时候，可能90%谈的是世界或世俗的，但是有10%是关于信仰的话题。
We want to engage the next generation.
所以，当我们想要能够触碰到下一代的时候
，But 90% of their thoughts are being transformed by the patterns of this world.
那我们要了解，他们接触到的90%的东西，可能是世界上的东西。
How are we going to change this?
那我们要如何可以改变这个呢？
So I think after COVID, as a leader, as many of us are in the room,
在新冠疫情之后
we need to decide: do we treat COVID as a blizzard or as an ice age?
我们就要想新冠所造成的是一个暂时的一个暴风雪，还是是一个长期的冰河时期？
This is really important.
这是一个很重要的问题。
A blizzard, you hunker down, you stay in your house, and it's over.
如果只是一个暂时的暴风雪，我们就躲在避风港里面一段时间，这个风雪会过去。
Not too much preparation needed.
我们不太需要做太多的预备。
But if it's an ice age,
但是如果是冰河时期，
some animals will become extinct.
有一些的动物它就会绝种。
So we need to continue to consider, is digital transformation that's needed a blizzard or an ice age?
所以我们当我们面对数位化的问题的时候，就我们就要想，这是一个长期的冰河时期吗？
Next slide, please. Thank you. So there's a mental model called unknown unknowns.
这是一个我们在思考的时候我们的一个模式，我们叫做未知或是知已知的模式。
It's really important to see that there's unknown unknowns in our minds.
在我们的脑海里面有一群是我们对自己也不了解，然后实际上我们都对那个是不清楚的。
Those are our blind spots.
这可以说就是我们的盲点。
There's actually very little that we know and then a little bit more that we don't know. So I want us to ask ourselves, are we in alignment with these three areas?
我们也来思考，在我们的信仰上面，这三个不同的方向是不是是合一的
？We tell our younger generation that we want to allow them to align their head, their heart, and their hands.
这三个方向就是我们的知识上、我们的情感上，还有我们的行为上面。
But based on my experience, I believe that our head is full of knowledge, our heart full of passion.Our hands are actually very small.
常常我们会遇到的是，我们可能有很多的知识，我们的头脑非常大，我们有很多的情感，我们有很多的热情，但是我们的行动常常是少的。
Even more so, if we're talking about the elephant in the room,
当我们讲房间里大象的时候
，there's very little opportunities for the next generation to participate.
我们就看到，对于下一个新的世代，其实他们好像很少有机会参与这样的讨论。
If I'm a software developer,
如果我是软件开发工程师
，I'm asked to do what?
我的工作是什么
？Lead the worship team。
我可能是要带敬拜
，maybe， or maybe lead an inductive study on Mark。
或者是带查经
，most likely advance a PowerPoint slide。
但是常常我在教会可能被要求的只是在那边放 PPT 而已。
How could somebody that make over $150,000 just click on it?Button every single week.
那我们就在想，一年可能是一个很高收入的电脑工程师，但是他每个礼拜在教会就是在那边放 PPT.
How do we expand the opportunities, the hands for these people?
那我们如何可以让那些人的手、那些人的行动可以发挥更大的效力
？Next slide, please. And so, before the next generation becomes fully disengaged, digital transformation.Innovation and collaboration must be implemented.
在下一个世代完全的去脱离之前，我们必须要想在数位化上面，我们可以做什么样的改变跟创新。
This was a recent article from EMQ, and it says the current pathway for global missions only empowers 1% of Christians to serve as missionaries.
这是一个统计的数字，我们看到现在的这个发展，在全球化的这个宣教当中，可能只有让1%的福音派的基督徒有机会参与宣教。
And Michael O from Lausanne actually apologized to the 99% for this 1%.
只有1%的人有机会去当宣教士，所以其实我们需要对那99%的人去道歉。
There's one more article here saying the current generation stands at a unique point and fulfill the Great Commission.
但是我们也知道，我们现在的世代是在一个特殊的时候，我们能够来完成大使命。
Each of us in the room have a chance to develop new opportunities that motivate the next generation to pursue godly living, evangelism, and discipleship.
因为你跟我在这个房间里面，我们都有权利也有责任，让下一个世代可以更多的参与大使命。
So there's this another mental model called Dunbar's number.
这个叫做一个邓巴数。
Each of us can maintain 150 relationships.
这大概是说一个人能够去紧密维持的人际关系，大概是有一个上限，通常说是150左右。
Even if you have 1,500 people on Facebook.
就算你在脸书上面有几千个朋友。
Maximum, you reach about 150 people that you message with or check their stats.
但你有紧密保持联系的，大概就是150个左右。
I want to ask each of us.
我想要挑战大家。
How many young people are in your network?
那在你在这些连结当中，有多少人是年轻的人呢？
If we want to pass the baton to the next generation,
如果我们要交棒给下一代，
we need those people in our network.
那你就需要把这些人放在你的紧密社交圈。
We need them to go beyond the 150.
你就必须要超越这150个这个限制。
Maybe be part of the 50.
也许是。让他进到你最熟、最亲密的那五十个里面。
Maybe identify them to be the 15.
也许是你更紧密的那十五个人之一。
And hopefully they could become the 5.
也许在最后是你最亲密的那五个门徒之一。
And so we want to talk about digital strategies.
当我们要讲数位化的策略的时候
，There's innovation.
我们需要创新。
Community building.
我们需要建立社交团体。
Accessibility.
我们需要让别人可以很轻易的拿到这个资讯
，and all of these things will be able to engage the next generation.
这些东西都可以帮助我们跟下一代更紧密连接。
And I want to walk you through a typical missions journey.
我们来想一下在宣教上面的一个旅程。
Maybe a young adult goes to church.
也许一个社青的年纪的人他去教会。
He goes to a great missions conference, maybe another missions conference in Taiwan or somewhere else.
他去了一个很棒的宣教年会。
He goes to do a short-term missions.
他去短宣。
He takes a great perspective class.
他也许上了这个宣教新视野这类的课程。
Between the missions conference and the missions class, what is this person supposed to do?
那在他去上这些宣教课程，到他要去宣教，他要做什么呢？
There's a very, very long gap.
通常在这段期间有一个很长的等待的时间。
We're praying and hoping they'll just somehow maintain their fire for missions.
所以我们常常就希望神奇的可以为他们祷告，让他们继续保持这个宣教的火。
But all the while, the church is not encouraging them.
但是在这段等待的时间当中，教会并不一定真正的能够帮助鼓励他们。
We saw the research today.
我们看到这个数字统计的数字。
Discipleship, Bible study.
门训、查经
，top three.It was the top three Bible study, fellow, discipleship, but local missions, global missions, it was very low on the list.
就是在我们的地方教会当中最常在做的可能就是门训、查经，但是宣教常常是放在比较低的地位。
Have we considered that the younger generation is the missing pieces for our Lego piece?
我们有没有想过，也许我们的下一代正是我们缺乏的拼图的那一块？
How might we fill the gaps between next generation and global missions?
全球的宣教跟下一代中间的关联是什么
？And so as we went through the pandemic, we considered how can we reimagine missions, and we said if we're doing remote work, why can't we do remote missions?
在疫情的时候，我们就想，既然可以在家上班，可以远距上班，那为什么不能远距宣教呢
？All of the pastors,
所有的牧师
，relax.
不要担心，不要紧张。
We're not telling you that they're not going to go in person anymore.
我们不是说不再需要派人去宣教工厂。
We're just asking to start from white belt to yellow belt.
我们只是从最初级的白带可以升级一下。
To do remote work, remote missions.
既然我们可以远距上班，也许远距宣教也是一个机会。
And we're going to help them get up to speed onto local in-person missions.
那最终当然我们可以帮助他们去进入宣教工厂。
So we want to support and supplement.
所以我们比较是一个辅助的工具。
We're not substituting incarnational missions.
并不是要取代道成肉身的宣教。
And so I just want to talk about a few things with.Some of our graphics for the next generation.
我们稍微用这些图来思考一下概念。
We're one body, many parts.
我们是同一个身体里面不同的肢体。
Can we entrust the next generation to lead us from time to time?
那我们愿不愿意交棒信任下一代的人来做这样的领导的工作呢
？We want to be able to help them to take a spot when we can help them lead.
我们是不是可以让他们来当这个领导者？我们帮助他们成为领袖
？Also, I want to talk about this concept of making paper airplanes.
我稍微来讲一下造纸飞机。
Next generation should be seen as part of the solution and not the problem.
下一代呢，其实不是我们的问题，而是应该是我们解决问题的答案。
And next generation is not a project for all of us.
同时它也不是只是一个我想要完成的一个事工而已。
Nobody wants to be treated as a project.
因为我们下一代其实它不是一个我们想要去做的事工。
We talked about from other speakers today.
今天在稍早我们已经有听到，没有人希望被当成是一个事工。
We want to be loved.
我们希望被爱。
And so, if there are ways for us to do that, let's look at the next slide. It's Can we say more yes and instead of yes but?
我们可以更多的说好，而不是好但是。
This 但是 is very, very important.
这个但是是非常重要的一个字。
Imagine I ask him, I want to go eat 臭豆腐。
我们假想一下，假设他跟我说想要去吃臭豆腐。
But he says yes, but.
然后我说好啊，但是。
Every time he says but, it's a wet blanket.
每一次给出一个但是的时候，其实也代表了一个拒绝。
It's also tearing me down.
是一个拆毁的工作。
Young people come to us all the time with their ideas.
当年轻人来找我们谈他们的想法的时候
，We keep saying yes, but.
我们常常会说好，但是。
Next year.
明年。
No budget.
没有资金。
Not in scope.
不是我现在想做的这个范围里面。
Let's figure out how to allow them to make the right size paper airplanes.
我们要帮助他们如何的能够去做一个好的纸飞机呢？
How can we match their affinity and their ability with the right opportunities?
如何的我们可以把他们的对一个事情的热情跟喜爱加上他们的能力，但是又给他们机会去发展。
We're able to mobilize these young adults because we lower the friction by finding the right size opportunity.
那很重要的就是我们帮助他们去减少那个摩擦力，所以他们比较容易能够上手进入。
And so I want to just talk about one cohort program.
其中一个大家也许熟悉的就是约书亚计划。
And so this was our first cohort.
这是一个约书亚计划当中的一个伙伴团体。
This was during the middle of the pandemic.
这是我们在疫情当中发展的。
These people have never met each other.
这些人他们彼此不认识。
They're all from different parts of the U.S.
他们都是在美国不同的地方。
They wanted to use their skills for missions.
但是他们有在这个里面受了一样的训练跟参与这一个。
And so over one semester, they were able to create a marketing campaign for Joshua Project.
所以他们就为约书亚计划去做了一个市场的一个广告。
Another group of kids.
另外一群人。
This one, they were all from the local church.
他们都是在同一个地方教会。
The brother on the left here, he draws for DreamWorks and Disney.
其中的一个弟兄呢，他是帮迪士尼在画动画的。
He doesn't get asked to draw for anything much at church.
但是在教会当中，他没有什么机会来画。
We asked him, "Would you like to draw for Jesus?"
我们就问说，你愿不愿意为耶稣来画
？Would you like to draw for missions?
你愿不愿意为宣教来画
？He said yes.
他说好。
We said yes, and he recruited five more students with him.
我们就说好，然后来做这些事。
And this prayer guide is now translated into 8 languages.
那接下来这个还会被翻译成很多不同的语言。
It's become over 5,000 copies sold.
已经卖出超过5,000份。
And we'll now share one story about this young man.
我要分享一下这个年轻人的故事。
What happens when the church doesn't value marketplace talent?
当教会没有去注重这些年轻人他们在工作上面的恩赐的时候
，Where do they find their value?
那他们的价值在哪里可以找到呢
？So I met this young man.
我就遇到这个年轻人。
When he was 8 years old.
我遇到他的时候他八岁。
I was his VBS teacher.
我是他的暑期圣经学校的老师。
I went overseas to missions.
接下来我就去海外宣教。
I came back.
我回来之后。
And I found out he was making videos for a Buddhist ministry.
我就发现他在为这个佛教的团体来做影片。
And he was in Beverly Hills.
他住在比佛利山庄。
And I was like, what happened?
我就问他说发生什么事呢
？How could you be making videos for the other team?
为什么你在为佛教团体在做影片呢？
And I was like, maybe you're being the salt and light in their darkness.
你是想要在黑暗当中做光做盐吗
？He's like, no, I couldn't find a job, and they gave me a job.
他的回答其实很简单，就是没有其他人给我工作，但这个佛教团体给我工作机会。
I was brokenhearted.
我当时觉得很难过。
And so I prayed.
我就祷告。
I said, why don't you move over from Los Angeles to Dallas?
我就问他说，你愿不愿意从洛杉矶搬到达拉斯
？I will find you a job.
我为你找一个工作。
We will figure it out.
我们可以一起来找出一个方法。
Yes and.
我就是给他好，然后。
And 3 years later, he's been living with us, and by God's grace, he's been serving a lot of different ministries.
三年后，他跟我一样在达拉斯，而且为很多基督教的机构来工作。
By God's grace, we're able to say yes to one student.
因为耶稣的恩典，我们可以跟这一个年轻人说好，然后我们可以一起做什么。
But how many more students are out there that don't have a yes and?
那有多少在外面的年轻人没有这样的机会，是得到好然后的这个机会呢？
This is another example where we recruited college students to build a Bible Story app.
这是另外一个例子，我们一起来研发了这个 APP， 讲到圣经故事的 APP.
This Korean sister was crying because she felt so encouraged that she would say, "I could use my skills for missions."
这个韩裔的姐妹呢，她其实已经非常的难过。她说她想要用她的这个技巧恩赐来服事
，but there's no place to use it.
但是我没有机会参与任何宣教的服事。
And somehow we got connected to her.
那我们有机会跟他连接。
We provided a small opportunity.
我们先给他小的机会。
And so I think there's many, many things for us to consider.
所以在这当中，我们可以有很多不一样的想法。
Maybe you don't draw.
也许你不一定会画图。
Maybe you're not a developer.
也许你不一定能够发展网路。
Do you know how to use Google?
但是你会用 Google 吗
？And so we start doing research.
我们就开始研究。
And so we research for different organizations like Ralph Winter's Launch Lab, Christian Vision. We work with DXM in Lausanne.
我们就跟不同的，我们就 Google 不同的宣教的机构或是宣教的团体。
For this last report, there's 3 billion video gamers.
在最后的这一个，它实际上有30亿个游戏网络游戏的玩家参与这个。
How are we going to reach the 3 billion gamers?
你如何可以去触碰到30亿个网络游戏的玩家
？Think about business as missions.
我们要想一下我们的工作上来宣教，这也许就是一种方法。
Business as missions in the frontier markets, all the easy places are taken.
很多时候这种商业宣教啊什么，其实这些很简单的东西，也许都已经有人在做。
So we need to figure out a way to enter the country.
那我们需要做的就是我们要如何知道能够进去这个国家。
And so by God's grace,
因为上帝的恩典
every summer we have 15 interns.
每个暑假我们有15个实习生
from Ivy League schools,
从常春藤学校
Christian colleges,
基督徒的大学
and state universities,
到州立大学
and they all could collaborate together.
我们就一起合作
with young professionals, older advisors and mentors.
有社青也有一些辅导。
This is one feedback from the founder of Joshua Project.
他们就一起合作，这是其中一个刚刚说的约书亚计划一起合作的这一个里面，他的这个创始人。
Indigenous is doing a terrific job challenging a new generation to use their skills to advance the cause for unreached peoples.
这个创始人他的这个回应就是说 ，Indigenous 就是这一个机构做了非常好的，让下一个世代的人能够用他们的技巧在。得到未得之名上面。
This one student said, "Indigenous show me the future of missions in the digital age. We work on projects remotely with people we've never met. Yet the realm of digitalization does not change our unifying goal to let more people encounter God."
这是其中参与这个计划的一个学生，他说，Indigenous 这个机构让我们看到未来宣教在进入数位化的一个可能性，因为我们可以跟从来没有见过面的人一起，但是我们为了同一个，为了宣扬福音，我们为了同一个目标。
And I want to talk about how the older generation could help the younger generation.
我想要讲一下，年长的世代如何帮助年轻的世代。
During the 2020 Missions Conference,
在2020的一个宣教会
one of my mentors,
其中一个我的辅导
she told the organization leader Ted,
他就告诉Ted 就是这一个负责人
that I'm doing this ministry called Indigenous,
就介绍说Indigenous 的一个机构
Ted was very encouraged by this movement,
Ted 这个 leader 呢，他就觉得这样很棒。
He invited me to go on stage to share with the audience after the opening session.
就邀请 Andrew 能够上台去分享。
3 years later, just this past week, Nick was also on stage to give a talk.
三年之后，就是今年，Nick 就是我们刚刚讲到的那个学生，他也被在三年后，他被邀请上台去分享。
How can we imagine allowing young people to step on our shoulders to go farther?
我们还思考说，年轻人如何可以站在我们的肩膀上，让他们可以走得更远，看得更远。
Are we willing to sacrifice our notoriety?
我们愿意去牺牲我们的自己的一些名声吗
？This is another example.
这是另外一个例子。
There was another missions leader. She suggested that we should write an article for Mission Frontiers.
那个时候就说 Andrew 应该要写一个文章关于宣教的最前线。
To talk about how young people don't really know missions.
讲到年轻人他们不知道如何参与宣教。
And I got a chance to connect with Dr. Todd Johnson.
我就跟Todd Johnson有联系。
And then after that, one of our interns from our very, very first cohort back in 2020, she wanted to work for Gordon Seminary.
在2020，我们那时候的第一批的实习生，他想要进 Gordon Conwell 神学院。
And so we asked Todd Johnson to meet with her.
我们就请 Todd Johnson 能够跟他见面。
And she was so excited to have this opportunity.
他就有非常开，这个女生非常开心，这实习生非常开心有这个机会。
As an older brother or older sister in the room,
如果我们当中是比较年长的弟兄姐妹
，Will we be able to refer a resource, a recommendation, or a relationship?
你愿不愿意帮助介绍或者是给资源
？Over the last 3 years, we've been doing this for the cohort program.
在过去的三年，我们就继续用这些伙伴的这些关系
，completely remote.
完全都是线上，都是在家里面。
And during Urbana 2022,
在 Urbana 的这个宣教年会的2022年
，Yeah, everybody flew in from all across the U.S.
世界各地不同美国各地不同的人到的大学生或是年轻人到这个地方。
They're college students, so they should be attending the conference.
他们大部分都是大学生，所以他们就是来参加这个大学生宣教特会。
But because they believe in our movement,
但是因为他们相信，这样子的一个新的一个方法。
They were tabling being exhibitors on our side.
所以他们在参加的时候呢，他们愿意在我的机构的这个桌子。
And as we conclude,
当我在这边结束的时候
，I want to ask each of us,
我想要挑战每一个人。
What will you do to support the next generation?
你愿意为下一代的宣教事工做什么呢
？To truly own their missional calling.
你是不是真的愿意回应这样子的一个呼召
？What kind of opportunities are we creating?
你制造了什么样的机会
？Allow us continue to allow the opportunity for them to step on our shoulders so they could go farther.
让年轻的一代可以站在我们的肩膀上面，可以走得更远。
Thank you.
谢谢。